Hello viewers, welcome to the video on Introduction to Consistent Deformation Method. In this video, you will learn basic concepts in consistent deformation method, concepts and step-by-step procedure in analysis of propped cantilever, concepts and step-by-step procedure for analysis of fixed beam. Propped cantilever and fixed beam are the indeterminate structures. That means these structures cannot be analyzed using equations of equilibrium alone. So special methods are needed to analyze such type of structures. We can analyze these structures using consistent deformation method. Consistent deformation method is also known as Maxwell-Mohr method. As the indeterminate structures cannot be analyzed using equations of equilibrium, some special methods are required to analyze indeterminate structure. So, consistent deformation method is the first method which is developed for analysis of indeterminate structures. Consistent deformation method is a force method to analyze the indeterminate structure. If you want to understand what is meant by force method and displacement method, then you can watch the video on force method and displacement methods. I will provide the link in description box. So, consistent deformation method is a force method to analyze the indeterminate structure. That means, in this method, the primary unknown is redundant reactions at the support. This method is developed by Maxwell and Mohrs, and therefore it is called as Maxwell-Mohrs method. Consistent deformation method is more suitable when degree of static redundancy is less. Since the consistent deformation method is a force method, so in this method, the indeterminate structure is analyzed by satisfying conditions of deflection or rotation at the redundant reactions. Now, what does it mean? Let us consider a propped cantilever. So, if you consider this support, this is a fixed support. So, here we have condition of deflection, that deflection at A, that is delta A, is zero. We also have rotation at fixed support is equal to zero, that is theta A equal to zero and delta A equal to zero. These are the conditions available at support A. Similarly, at support B, we have condition of deflection, that delta B equal to zero. But rotation at this simple end is not equal to zero. So in this structure, we have three conditions available, that theta A equal to zero, delta A equal to zero, and delta B equal to zero. So, these are the conditions available for propped cantilever. If it is a fixed beam, then in fixed beam, both the supports are fixed support. So, in this case, we have at A, the condition available is delta A equal to zero and theta A equal to zero. Similarly, at support B also, delta B equal to zero and theta B equal to zero. If the beam is symmetrical, in that case, we have one more condition available. So, you know that in case of symmetrically loaded fixed beam, then slope at mid-span, that is center of the span, is also equal to zero. So, this one more condition is available when the beam is symmetrically supported and symmetrically loaded. Now let us understand how we can apply this consistent deformation method for analysis of propped cantilever. What is propped cantilever? You must be knowing the meaning of cantilever beam. Cantilever beam has fixed support at one end and it is free at other end. In cantilever beam, there are three reactions at support A and no reaction at free end B. So since there are three reactions and we have three equations available to solve this structure, this cantilever beam is a determinate structure. Such structure is called as determinate structure or isostatic structure. But since this end is free end, there can be large deflection at free end. So sometimes the support is provided at the free end to reduce deflection at B, that is at free end. This support is called as prop. Now, due to this prop, there is additional unknown reaction. So total number of reactions are 4, while number of equations available are 3. So when number of equations available are less than number of unknown reaction, then such structure is called as indeterminate structure or hyperstatic structure. So when the support is provided at the free end, this structure is called as propped cantilever. Due to additional support at free end, the structure becomes indeterminate and this structure, that is propped cantilever, has static indeterminacy equal to 1. So this is a cantilever beam and this is called as propped cantilever beam. In propped cantilever beam, there are 4 reactions and we have 3 equations available to solve this structure. So total 4 reactions, equations are 3. So one reaction is redundant, which is extra. So in this case, the degree of static indeterminacy in propped cantilever is 4 minus 3, which is equal to 1. So degree of static indeterminacy of propped cantilever is 1. Now let us understand how to analyze this propped cantilever using consistent deformation method. To analyze a propped cantilever, you have to remember 7 important steps. So let us understand one by one these 7 important steps. Step number 1. As we know that for propped cantilever, degree of static indeterminacy is equal to 1, we have to consider any one reaction as a redundant force. So in propped cantilever, vertical reaction at the prop or movement at the fixed support can be taken as redundant force. But it is convenient to take reaction at prop, that is this reaction, as a redundant force. Therefore, we consider reaction at B, that is RB, as a redundant force. So what is step number 1? Consider RB as redundant force. Step 2. Split the beam in 2 parts. Now in this case, as we have considered RB as redundant force, we have to remove this RB and make the structure determinate. So this structure is split up like this. First of all, remove this redundant force. It will become a cantilever beam. So consider the beam without prop and only with the given load. So you have to split up into two parts. So in first case, you have to remove the reaction, consider a cantilever beam with given load. And then in second case, remove the load and consider only this reaction. Consider this reaction as a redundant force on the structure. Now you know that you have to calculate this delta 1 at the free end and delta 2 at this free end due to redundant reaction. We know that there cannot be any deflection at B. So we can apply the compatibility condition that delta 1 plus delta 2 is equal to 0. So since deflection at prop means here at B is equal to 0, the compatibility condition is delta 1 plus delta 2 is equal to 0. So this is the important step in analysis of propped cantilever. So what is step number 2? We have to split this given beam into two parts. In first beam, you have to remove the redundant reaction. Consider the beam only with load. In second case, consider the beam only with redundant reaction. Remove the load and calculate the deflection in first part and second part and apply the compatibility condition, that is delta 1 plus delta 2 is equal to 0. This is step number 2. In step number 2, we have seen that we have to split up the beam into two parts and we have to calculate delta 1 and delta 2. Now, how to calculate this delta 1? That is step number 3. So, to calculate this delta 1 due to given load, we have to use any method of calculation of deflection like conjugate beam method, moment area method, etc. So, here I am using moment area method to calculate delta 1. So what moment area method says? To calculate deflection at B using moment area method for this cantilever beam, the deflection is given by AX bar upon EI. Now what is A? For the given beam, for the given load, you have to draw bending moment diagram. And if you calculate the area of the bending moment diagram due to load, that is this A. What is A? A is area of bending moment diagram due to this given load. Then X bar. X bar is distance of CG of BMD from support B. So you have to calculate the CG of that bending moment diagram and take the distance from B. Why we are taking distance from B and not from A? Because we are calculating deflection at B. So we have to take the distance from that point where you want to calculate the deflection. And therefore, by using moment area method, that is by using this expression AX bar upon EI, we can calculate delta 1. Step 4 is to calculate the deflection at B due to this redundant reaction at B. It is a standard case of cantilever subjected to point load at free end. Only thing is the load is not downward but it is upward. And this RB we consider as a load on this cantilever beam and we can use the standard formula to calculate delta 2. So the standard formula is PL cube upon 3EI. So P is RB. So we get delta 2 is equal to RB L cube upon 3EI. So this is step number 4. Step 5. After calculating delta 1 and delta 2, you have to apply geometric compatibility equation to calculate RB. Now delta 1 is due to load, that will be some value. Delta 2 is due to RB. So it will be in terms of RB. So when you apply the condition, what is the compatibility condition available here? It is deflection at prop is equal to zero. So when you apply delta 1 plus delta 2 is equal to zero, delta 1 is some value due to load and delta 2 is in terms of RB. So after applying this condition, you will get the value RB. Once you get RB, you can calculate other reactions, that is the reactions at support A using conditions of equilibrium. So step number 5 is to apply geometric compatibility equation and calculate RB, that is redundant reaction. Step 6, after calculating RB, you can calculate reactions at other support, that is at support A, by applying 3 equations of equilibrium, that is summation of vertical forces equal to zero, summation of moment equal to zero, etc. And the last step is to draw shear force diagram and bending moment diagram if required. If it is asked in the example to draw SFD and BMD, then you have to draw this SFD and BMD, that is step number 7. So 7 important steps in analysis of propped cantilever includes step number 1, choose redundant force. Step 2, split the beam in 2 parts after removing the redundant force. Step number 3 is calculate deflection at free end using moment area method. So we calculate the deflection due to load at the free end using moment area method, that is delta 1 AX bar upon EI. Then step number 4 is calculate deflection at B due to redundant reaction, for which we use the standard formula, that is PL cube upon 3EI, where P is the redundant reaction. Step number 5 is to apply the geometric compatibility equation to calculate RB. So using this equation, we calculate this redundant reaction RB. Once you calculate RB, then you can calculate the reaction at fixed support by applying conditions of equilibrium. And the last step is to draw shear force diagram and bending moment diagram. I hope you must have understood the 7 important steps in analysis of propped cantilever. Now we will see the analysis of fixed beam. There are 5 important steps in analysis of fixed beam. So let us understand these steps. What is meant by fixed beam? So when both the supports of the beam are fixed support, such beam is called as fixed beam. Now, when such beam is subjected to only vertical load, there are 4 reactions in the structure, 2 vertical reactions and 2 moments at the fixed end. There will not be any horizontal reaction since the load is vertical. So when load is vertical, total number of reactions are 4. And when the load is vertical, available equilibrium conditions are 2. That is summation of vertical forces equal to zero and summation of moment equal to zero. We cannot apply summation of horizontal forces equal to zero. So we have 4 unknown reactions and 2 equilibrium condition. So degree of static indeterminacy when the fixed beam is subjected to only vertical load is 2. But if there is inclined load, in such case, horizontal reaction cannot be 0. So in that case, there will be 3 reactions at support A, that is one vertical, one horizontal, and one moment, and 3 reactions at support B. That is, total number of reactions are 6 and total available equations are 3. That is, summation of vertical forces equal to 0, summation of horizontal forces equal to 0, and summation m equal to 0. In such case, the degree of static indeterminacy of fixed beam will be 3. So remember that for the same beam, if the load is only vertical, then in case of fixed beam, degree of static indeterminacy is 2. Whereas if the load is inclined, then in that case, the degree of static indeterminacy is 3 for fixed beam. Now we will understand analysis of fixed beam using consistent deformation method. We will see the step-by-step procedure for analysis of fixed beam. Step 1. Suppose this is the given beam, given fixed beam, subjected to only vertical load. In such case, degree of static indeterminacy is 2. So we have to consider two reactions as redundant forces. So in fixed beam, we consider fixed end moment at both the supports as redundant reaction. So these moment MAB and MBA is considered as redundant reaction. So step number one is split the beam into two parts. So first we remove the redundant reaction. So if you remove the redundant reaction, that is the fixed end moments, the beam become a simply supported beam. So we split the beam like this. First we remove the redundant reactions, that is moments. It becomes simply supported beam with load. And second, we consider only the effect of fixed end moment. So this given beam is a combination of these two beams. So this fixed beam is divided or split up into two parts. First is simply supported beam with only load, and second is simply supported beam with only redundant forces. So this is step number one. In step number two, we draw the bending moment diagram for this split up beams. That is, we have to draw two bending moment diagram. So we have to draw the bending moment diagram of simply supported beam for given load, and we have to calculate its area and distance of CG from any support. Similarly, we have to draw the bending moment diagram due to these moments MAB and MBA. So since the bending moment diagram due to downward load is sagging, I have drawn here positive sign, and bending moment diagram due to support reaction, that is moments, is hogging at both the ends. Here I am considering negative sign. So bending moment diagram due to downward load is positive, that is sagging, and due to fixed end moment is negative, that is hogging. So step number two is to draw the bending moment diagram and calculate the area of the diagram and distance of CG of the diagram. Now, once you draw the bending moment diagram and calculate area of the diagram and distance of CG, step number three is to apply the compatibility equation. Now, in this case, the degree of indeterminacy is 2. So we have considered two moments as redundant forces, and therefore there are two unknowns in this structure. And so we will need two compatibility equations to solve two unknowns. So first compatibility equation we use, that slope at A equal to 0. So using moment area method, slope corresponds to area of bending moment diagram. So we take area of this diagram and area of this diagram and equate it to 0, because slope at A due to fixity is 0. So A1 plus A2 is equal to 0, is the first compatibility condition. Now, in this equation, there will be two unknowns because this area of trapezium contains MAB and MBA. A1 will be known, some value will be there due to load for A1. But for A2, A2 is the equation in terms of MAB and MBA. So there will be two unknowns in A2. So overall, this equation will have two unknown quantities, that is MAB and MBA. So first compatibility condition is slope at A equal to zero. And by moment area method, slope means area of bending moment diagram between two points. So slope at A is also zero and slope at B is also zero. So we have to take the area between A to B. And therefore, we get equation A1 upon EI plus A2 upon EI is equal to zero. So this is the first compatibility equation. Then second compatibility equation is deflection at A equal to zero. And by moment area method, we know that deflection is AX bar upon EI is equal to zero. So we can write A1X1 upon EI plus A2X2 upon EI is equal to zero. So this equation also contains two unknowns, that is MAB and MBA. So what is step number three? Step number three is to apply compatibility equation. That is slope at A equal to zero and deflection at A equal to zero. So in step number three, we will get two simultaneous equation. So solving these two simultaneous equation, we will get fixed end moment, that is MAB and MBA. So our aim in analysis of fixed beam is to calculate fixed end moments. So using this, solving this simultaneous equation, you can calculate the fixed end moment in fixed beam. In step number five, this is the last step. After calculating the fixed end moment, you have to draw the bending moment diagram. Now in fixed beam, we draw bending moment diagram by superimposition. That means first we draw the bending moment diagram due to load over which we overlap the bending moment diagram due to fixed end moment. So load is normally the downward load. So diagram is normally the sagging diagram over which we overlap hogging diagram. So the portion which is the net effective, this will cancel each other, positive or negative, this portion. So this is sagging portion and this is the hogging portion. And this point where the bending moment changes its sign from positive to negative or negative to positive is called as point of contraflexure. So in fixed beam, we have two points of contraflexure, whereas in propped cantilever, normally we have one point of contraflexure. So for analysis of fixed beam, the five important steps includes, first is to split the beam in two parts, then to draw the bending moment diagram for each case. After that, we apply the compatibility equations, that is slope at A equal to zero and deflection at A equal to zero, from which we get two simultaneous equations. Then in step number four, we solve this simultaneous equation and calculate the fixed end moment. After calculating fixed end moment, the last step is to draw the bending moment diagram by superimposition. I hope you will find this video useful in analysis for analysis of propped cantilever and for analysis of fixed beam. In next video, we will solve numerical example on analysis of propped cantilever and fixed beam. In that video, I will explain to you. In next video, you will understand how to calculate reaction at prop support, then how to calculate reaction at other support, which is a fixed support, how to draw bending moment diagram and shear force diagram, then how to calculate the magnitude and position of maximum positive bending moment, and then how to locate the point of contraflexure. So these steps we will understand in next video. If you find this video useful, please share it for the benefit of other students. Thanks for watching.